Actually, I'm just being told, Tim, I'm sorry, this is a live picture from the Oval Office. That's President Trump with Joshua Holt, who is a young man that was imprisoned in Venezuela, who was freed today and brought back to the United States. The president about
thank you very much, everybody.
To address
this
the public. We'll take it to the Oval Office now.
We have, as you know, Josh Holt and his wife, Tammy, and they came back from a very tough ordeal in a Venezuelan prison, almost 2 years, Josh. And, you know, amazing that you were able to take it. Your daughter, Marion's here, and your parents, Jason and Lori, and you went through a lot, and you were in there fighting all the way. And I want to thank Bob Corker. Great job you did over there. Great job. And I want to thank Mike Lee and Mia. You've been from every time I'd see Mia, she'd talk about you, Josh. She'd say, what about you? I said, what about something else? Can we talk about something else? She was always doing it. And Orrin Hatch is a legend, as you know. He's a legend in the Senate and in this country. And Orrin, you were great. So Bob, Mike, Mia, Orrin, I want to thank you very much.
Thank you.
So we've had 17 prisoners released during the Trump administration. Most people don't know that. You remember Aya? We called the president of Egypt, and he released her. She was there for a long time, 3 years. And the previous administration was unable to get her out. A fantastic young woman, and she was released. As you know, in North Korea, we just had a very great success. We have three wonderful people, Americans, that were released just recently. And they're now home safe with their families. And you were a tough one, I have to tell you. That was a tough situation. But we've had 17 released, we're very proud of that record, very proud. And we have others coming. We're in the midst of some very big negotiations to get others out. In most cases, they're Americans, but we can try and help other countries, too, where there's injustice. So we've been working very hard on it. But I just want to welcome you to the Oval Office, welcome you to the White House. It's really very special to have you both. You've gone through a lot. You've gone through a lot, more than most people could endure. I want to thank your parents for being such loving parents. You were really very, very special. You were fighting all the way. There was not a day that — there wasn't an hour or a minute that you weren't thinking about this man and calling everybody and letting us know. And we are all, as a group, very happy. The State Department has been fantastic. Where are my guys from the State Department? Where are they?
John,
you have John Sullivan. You guys were really fantastic. Look at all those people that work at the State Department. You're probably surprised to see that. But maybe I'd like to ask the parents, your great parents, if you have something to say before. Well, I'd like to get to the senators, and I'd like to get to you, Mia, and ask you also. But could I start with the parents?
I just want to say thank you to you personally for everything that you've done, as well as the State Department, but all of you. I just can't even tell you. I've grown to love Senator Hatch and Mia so much. Not everybody gets to talk to Senator Hatch and Mia Love, and when everything happened last week, Mia was the one that answered her phone and was the one that got things rolling with Senator Hatch to save Josh. And
I've never seen Mia cry before.
It was a horrifying week, and she got me through it with Senator Hatch. Senator Hatch's office, I cannot tell you how much I love all of your staff. So thank you. And I also want to say thank you to President Maduro for releasing Josh and letting him come home.
That's very nice. Pop?
She pretty much said everything. That's why I let the pretty face take care of this kind of stuff. So
very smart. You're smart. Josh, would you like to say something?
I'm just overwhelmed with gratitude for you guys, for everything that you've done, for the support of my wife through those 2 years. They were very, very, very difficult 2 years. Not really the great vacation that I was looking for, but we're still together. Starting off a marriage rough, but now we're going to be together, and I'm just so grateful. for what you guys have done and for thinking about me and caring about me, just a normal person. So it really touches me, and thank you.
You've been very brave, actually. You've been incredibly brave. We saw what was happening inside of that prison. So you really have been very, very brave. Bob Corker, would you like to say something? Great job.
Well, thank you. We're just glad to have you home. A lot of people have worked for a long time to make this happen, and I want to thank everyone at the State Department. In particular, I want to thank Caleb McNary, who knows this area more than probably anybody in the United States. He's here with me today. But
where's Caleb?
Caleb.
Caleb, you're back.
Caleb. I'm back here.
Come on over here.
Hey, Caleb.
Experience that we could almost write a book about just the last 48 hours, but we're glad we're out. We were actually, Mr. President, taking off on the runway. Nothing in Venezuela happens quite in the same way that it happens here. And we were going down the runway, and they turned the engines off, and we turned around, so we still weren't sure we were leaving until.
What happened? Why did they do that?
There was an instrument issue that occurred, but it finally, we got out of there, and obviously Josh had a huge smile on his face. When we landed, he did.
Probably the only time that anybody was ever happy that there was a bad instrument on an airplane. That was a better alternative, yeah, right,
I
than
do
going
want to
back.
Say there were people that we worked with down there that I do hope at the right time you will have the chance to thank. There are people who really want to try to affect the relationship in a good way, they were very helpful to us in getting him out of there. I know you talked with one of them last night on the phone when I was having dinner with him, and I appreciate you doing so. Yeah.
That's great, Bob. That's really great. And, you know, we have Pastor Brunson, a wonderful Christian pastor, and he's right now in Turkey. He's been there a long time, and they say he's a spy, but he's not a spy. And we're going to all work, and we've been working for his release. He's having a hard time. There's a trial going on, but the trial is not so much of a trial. And we're talking to the folks in Turkey about doing something about it. But Pastor Brunson, I hope you can hear us. We'll be helping you at some point. We've been working on it for a while. It's been there a long time, and he's a totally innocent man. Mike Lee, would you like to say something?
Sure. I want to thank all those who have been involved in this, to Senator Corker, Senator Hatch, Representative Love, to Caleb, to the State Department, everyone who's been involved. Josh, I want to wish you a warm welcome home. We've missed you. We've prayed for you. And Miriam and Tammy, welcome to our country, which is now your country. Quisiera extender una bienvenida a ustedes, a nuestro país, que ahora es su país, nuestro país.
Very good. Well, you understood that beautifully. It's very good. Good job. Good job. Orrin Hatch, Senator, spectacular man. Please.
Mr. President, I can't tell you how much I appreciate you. As you know, I was the one guy who really supported you 100%.
Very early.
And I do now. Right. I think you're doing a terrific job, and this shows why we support you. You actually, this was, and I have to say, these folks did a great job. I was really thrilled with the way Bob handled himself. Caleb and others did such a good job. We have good people working with us. And the folks in this delegation all very sincerely want to get Josh out of there. And the parents are just as good a people as I've ever met in my life. And you better really live a good life. That's all I can say. But this wouldn't have happened without you. We just want you to know that, and when you look back over your tenure in the presidency, this is just one of the many great things you're doing. But it's really a great thing. And to know that we can rely on you and count on you and talk to you and meet with you These are all very important things. We love you, boy, and we just want to support you every way we can.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. And you've all been very supportive, but I really appreciate that. That's very nice. I thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mia?
I've been thinking about what I was going to say today, and it's been an emotional day. But so many Utah families send their families out, send their sons and daughters out to for maybe a year and a half to 2 years, and they want to know that they've got, if something happens to their children, that they've got someone, or the United States will have their back. And I don't think that there is a person in the United States right now that doesn't realize that you have their back. And so I wanted to personally thank you for keeping a promise that you made to me. Every time I would go and see you, I would bring up Joshua's name, and you would say, I'm going to do everything I can. And obviously, I believe it. I also wanted to say to Josh that your mom never let us forget about you.
That's right.
She is one of the strongest women I know. And we have started a friendship that started through maybe some heartache and some pain, but we are going to be friends forever because of the bond that we have had. And so, you know, I just wanted to say sincerely that we are with you. Utah has been praying for you and so happy that you're coming home. And Utah wants to thank you, Mr. President, for making this happen. We wouldn't have been able to do this without you. Everybody here, Senator Hatch, Mike Lee, Bob Corker, I mean, the State Department, we all work together to make this happen. And, you know, you don't know us, but we know you very well, Joshua, and we welcome you home.
Thank you very much, Mia. It is true, though. Every time I'd see Mia, I said, look, don't mention the name Joshua Holt. We're doing it. But she didn't forget. She was out there pitching, as was Bob, as was Mike, as was Orrin. I mean, we really had a great team. That's a strong nucleus right there, but we had a great team. Great job. I just want to mention we're doing very well in terms of the summit with North Korea. Looks like it's going along very well. There are meetings going on as we speak in a certain location, which I won't name, but you like the location. It's not so far away from here. And I think there's a lot of goodwill. I think people want to see if we can get the meeting and get something done. If we got that done and if we can be successful in the denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula, it would be a great thing for North Korea. It would be a great thing for South Korea. It would be great for Japan and great for the world, great for the United States, great for China. A lot of people are working on it. It's moving along very nicely. So we're looking at June 12th in Singapore. That hasn't changed. And it's moving along pretty well. So we'll see what happens. Okay? Thank you all very much. We appreciate it. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, everyone. Let's keep moving. Thank you. Thank you.
Those talks have gone very well. They've gone very well. I'm fully impressed. The talks have gone very, very well. I'd rather not say, but the talks have gone very well.